All sides expect this case to go to the Supreme Court, and I guess all sides expect Justice Anthony Kennedy to be the swing vote. Let's take a look at his record over the years on this issue. In 2003, Justice Kennedy wrote the opinion invalidating a Texas law that made gay sex a crime. In 2007, he struck down a Colorado provision that prohibited anti-discrimination ordinances that would protect gays. Question, what do you make of Justice Kennedy's record on these issues?
Justice Kennedy, like the other eight justices on the Supreme Court, are going to look at this issue, and most importantly, they're going to look at the overwhelming record produced by this trial. This judge, this district judge, the trial judge in California, the federal judge in California, listened to all the evidence. We put on 9 expert witnesses, 7 lay witnesses, and the other side really produced no evidence at all. In fact, they said during the course of the trial, they didn't need to prove anything. They didn't have any evidence. They didn't need any evidence. This is an overwhelming record that supports the fact that individuals are being hurt, and it helps no one in California, and California has no rational basis for continuing this discrimination. When that gets to the Supreme Court, I think that will be persuasive to all of the justices on the Supreme Court.
So you think you're going to win in the Supreme Court?
Well, we are not taking anything for granted. The Supreme Court justices will decide the case when it gets there. But we believe that we're right under the Constitution. This judge, if you read his 136-page opinion that analyzes every single issue, every single piece of evidence bearing on this case, decided that this discrimination is wrong, it's unconstitutional, it should be stopped. We are hopeful and reasonably confident that the Supreme Court, when we get there, will agree with that.
Finally, we got about a minute left. Let's talk a little bit about Ted Olson. As we said at the top of this segment, your conservative credentials are unquestioned. You argued and won Bush v. Gore, which ended up in the election of President George W. Bush. You were his first Solicitor General. And a lot of people have asked me, so I want to ask you, why did you get involved in this cause? And is it in fact the case that Hollywood director and liberal Rob Reiner was the one who got you to take on the case?
Well, there's a lot of people that asked me to take on this case. Chris, we believe that a conservative value is stable relationships and a stable community and loving individuals coming together and forming a basis that is a building block of our society, which includes marriage. We believe that that is a conservative value. We also believe that it's an important conservative value to sustain the rights of liberty of our citizens and to eliminate discrimination on invidious bases, whether it's race or sex or sexual orientation. It should be a liberal and a conservative value. It is a fundamental American value. All men and all women are created equal under the law.
Mr. Olson, we want to thank you so much for joining us today. We'll keep following your lawsuit. And I got to say, after your appearance today, I don't understand who you ever lost a case in the Supreme Court, sir.
You're very kind, Chris. Thank you for having me on your program.